redistricting process is underway in Pennsylvania. I'm Jill Horner. This is Comcast Newsmakers. With me is Pennsylvania State Representative Pam DeLissio. Thanks for being with us.
Hi, Jill. Thank you.
Two different processes underway at this point. There's the congressional level, but right now we're talking about what's happening at the state level when it comes to districts in Pennsylvania. We remember filling out our census forms. How does that have an impact on what's happening right now with redistricting?
Well, every 10 years we do a census, which tells us how many people live in which geographies, and then we need to rebalance both state representative districts and state senatorial districts so that they have equal population.
Now, that's the process underway at this point, and in every state it works in a different way, how these districts are redrawn. Some have elected representatives actually redraw these districts, some have more citizen participation. How does it work in Pennsylvania?
Well, in Pennsylvania it is a partisan event. There are two Democrats, one from the House, State House, one from the State Senate, who participate on the five-member commission. There are two Republicans, again, one from the State House, one from the State Senate, and then a chair of the commission that is mutually elected by those four parties. And if those four parties cannot agree on a chairperson, the Supreme Court of PA selects that chairperson, and that's what happened this year. It went to the Supreme Court, and the Chief Justice approved a judge from Delaware County who reflects the majority party's Republican.
So that's the process at this point. Where does the process now stand? Because this has been an ongoing process.
Yes, it started last spring when the data was collected. We are at October 31st. The preliminary plan was voted on by the commission, and it was a 3-2-0 vote. Three folks voted for it, two people voted against it. And that's very unusual. Usually by the time the preliminary plan comes together, there's consensus that this is a good plan for the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania. Unfortunately, the Democrats could not cast an affirmative vote because they hadn't seen the preliminary plan until literally about a half hour before they had a vote on it.
Now, when we talk about what's taken into consideration with a plan like this, there are a variety of different factors. There's geography, as you mentioned. There are often demographics taken into consideration. What should be considered when it comes to drawing boundaries?
Well, it's population is what drives it. And then keeping neighborhoods whole and communities whole as communities and neighborhoods function, you know, naturally with each other. Unfortunately, what happens when we have partisan commissions like we do in Pennsylvania, the concerns become creating safe districts so that there are no challengers or from one party to the other, or even no challengers within a primary, within a party. This becomes very much about power control and job security as opposed to what's best for the citizens.
Is there public input in this process?
The public input has been, it's extremely light given the magnitude of what this represents for the next 10 years. There is one scheduled public hearing that's been scheduled for this event. There is a 30-day public comment period. But again, overall, public input is very light given the magnitude of what this represents.
I know this is a concern for you in terms of the way in which this is conducted in Pennsylvania, but this is a process conducted every 10 years. What then happens for the next 10-year cycle? What should happen, in your opinion?
Well, we'll be living with this for the next 10 years, whatever the outcome is, and I think citizens really need to understand the current process in Pennsylvania, educate themselves to best practices in other states, and lobby and advocate hard over the next half dozen years so that our next redistricting is a nonpartisan event and that this redistricting will not be drawn in a way that benefits those who are elected officials and hold the power, but benefits the citizens.
Thanks so much for being with us.
Thank you.
We've been talking with Pennsylvania State Representative Pam DeLissio. I'm Jill Horner for Comcast Newsmakers.